my channel. If you're brand new, my name is Jessica Alexandria. I'm the creator of Bahati Life Apothecary. I'm a professional tarot astrologer and intuitive. As I'm sitting here, I feel like, yup, missing cards. Be right back. All right, let's try that again. Hello, everyone. Welcome back to my channel. If you're brand new, my name is Jessica Alexandria. I'm the creator of Bahati Life Apothecary. I'm a professional tarot astrologer and intuitive. It's so good to have you here. This video is going to be an interesting one, I think. That's the vibe that it is I'm getting from it. Number one, there's just so much information that I'm going to be unpacking. And I was debating, how am I feeling? Do I want to do a pick a card reading? Do I want to focus more on the astrological transits, the things that, you can expect? So we're just going to wing it. We're going to see what happens. I'm going to shuffle the cards. I think that's what it is that I'm going to do. So for those of you guys that don't know, or if you're brand new to the YouTube channel and you haven't heard me say this before, we've never met and we're meeting for the first time. Hey, what's up? Hello, welcome. But I've been saying for years that 2020 was going to be a game-changing year, and it obviously has been. This is predominantly because of Jupiter, Pluto, Saturn moving through the sign of Capricorn, just doing the most damage. That means that they were single-handedly working to destroy and break down and dismantle the world as we know it. Not only where you're at, but all of us collectively. There is this idea years ago that I just kept seeing it getting striked out by the universe, by my guides, by messengers that were coming through and being like, listen, this idea, you against me, or what, you know, what is happening over there is only impacting them. It's never going to impact us. I kept saying, I was like, give in the years to come, starting, you know, this is about 5 years ago, the world is going to start becoming a very small place. This means that we're going to see how much connected we all are. Not only was I seeing this shift, this change in our government policies, businesses, entrepreneur type energies, establishments, things like that, but our spiritual community collectively as a whole was going to be going through a massive change. What does that mean? Is that all good or all bad? That's the question that I always get, Jess. What's going to happen? What's happening? What can we expect? Is this bad? Is this evil? Number one, as a spiritual teacher, as a spiritual provider and studier and pursuer, I have realized over the years that there's no such thing as good or bad. It just is what it is. However, every planet and everything has an energy to it, and that energy reveals itself in the way that the door is open to expressing itself. That's what we see in the laws of attraction. That's what we see with manifestation, setting intention, candle magic, etc., etc. So it depends on your intention. It depends on what's happening in the world, how this energy will express itself, how this energy will reveal itself to you. If it's going to feel like a good thing or a bad thing, at the end of the day, it just is what it is. If you don't like your experience, then you can change it by, number one, shifting your perspective, number two, setting intention, and number three, moving differently, doing differently. I'm saying all of this to say, because there is a reason for that, that on the 12th, Jupiter and Pluto are going to be making an exact perfect conjunction. This means that the energies of Jupiter and the energy of Pluto are going to join forces together in the sign of Capricorn, where all of this major damage has been happening, has been occurring, not just in 2020, but the years before that. We're just seeing the result of it in 2020, if that makes any sense. The reason why we're seeing the result of it in 2020 is because we had all of these major planets going retrograde direct in the sign of Capricorn, highlighting it and focusing our energy in that area in a way that is so extreme, so major. We're seeing the full on breakdown. One thing I want to say really quickly before I dive into this, and as I just said that, there's an eagle that just flew, or an eagle or a hawk, I don't know what that was, big bird though, that just flew by the window. I don't know whose spirit animal that is. If it is yours, let me know down in the comments. But one thing I want to say about this is that as an astrologer, as an intuitive, it is my job, my responsibility, and I take it very seriously to give you guys 100% the truth, okay? I focus and I prioritize my precision and my accuracy and details and specifics. At the same time that I'm saying that, I want you guys to remember that look at that judgment day at the bottom of this deck, right? I'm working with the mermaid tarot. I'll link it down below in the description box and also in my comments. But these readings that I'm sharing with you guys are for a general audience, but they're specific messages. That's why they resonate so strong. That's why they resonate so truthful. That's how they impact. That's why it, you know, impacts your life, right? The thing is that I'm not pulling your personal chart. I'm not pulling the personal chart of the United States. I'm not pulling the personal chart of me or anyone else. I'm pulling the chart for the moment. So as I'm pulling the chart, the transits that are happening that were underneath, we're all collectively underneath it, but it's going to impact you in a very specific way, but it, you know, to your situation. So it might appear in your health. It might appear in your relationships. It might appear in your communication styles, your mental health, whatever. But for the most part, we're all under the same influence, right? As I'm saying that, you guys, keep that in mind, bear that in mind to where this might happen, where this might occur. Now, back to this week. Jupiter-Pluto conjunction in the sign of Capricorn is very intense. On a more intimate level, I'm going to start with you guys. I'm going to start talking about you and me and your best friend or your boyfriend or your girlfriend or whomever. On a more intimate level, Jupiter-Pluto conjunction is really triggering your sense, your personal sense of power, your ability to realize, I don't know why I'm hearing remote, so your ability to realize that certain things do not need to be accessible to you, that they should be separate away from you. This means that there are certain things that may be in your intimate life, especially as the sun is currently moving to the sign of Scorpio at the time of me filming this, especially as Mercury is moving into the sign of Scorpio this week, which is going to be happening on the 10th today, the time that is that I'm filming this. There are certain things, certain people, certain information, certain voices, certain energies that you are going to have to examine at the time of the at the time of this week specifically, but even more so this week with the Jupiter-Pluto conjunction in the sign of Capricorn and this hyper-focus on Scorpio energy. There are certain energies that you do not need to be hearing them on a more intimate level. They do not need to have too much access into your personal and private life. As I'm saying that, you guys, it's not just, this is what I'm getting, especially with the Judgment card here and especially with the Queen of Cups here. So, and this is just us getting started. It's 7 minutes into this video and we're already going in guns blazing. But there, it's not just these outside external things. It's what you're saying to yourself. It's what you will not allow yourself to release. It's what you will not allow yourself to express. It's what you will not allow yourself to experience. Scorpio energy rules regeneration. It rules the orgasm. It rules our body, our body's ability to release and to surrender, to let go. We cannot hold on to things that do not serve us because they will make us sick. They will make us toxic. It will become very toxic to our body. It will become poisonous. Some of you guys are holding on to and have a very intimate relationship with things that the universe and spirit and your higher self is urging you to release, is urging you. You can actually feel your body and your energy changing whenever that thought comes up or whenever you spend time with this certain person. Some of you guys, this is the week where you have to learn and you are going to hyper-focus. It's gonna begin, you're gonna begin to hyper-focus on, you know what, if I continue to think this way, if I continue to speak this way, if I continue to engage with these people in this way, I will only be able to experience bullshit, for lack of a better term. You will never be able to evolve. You will never be able to take that relationship to a deeper level. You will never be able to experience full health because of all of what it is that you're holding on to. In the astrological charts and in the spirituality community, with Neptune moving through the sign of Pisces, retrograde, Chiron retrograde in the sign of Aries, Mars retrograde in the sign of Aries as well. Mars is also going to be going direct on the 14th. And this Jupiter Saturn conjunction and the sun moving to the sign of Scorpio and Mercury moving into the sign of Scorpio, these energies right now are shifting you and are working to shift you, to heal you, but to help you to be more observant in a way that may make you feel like you're having a major ego death. It may make you feel like, who I am is not, or how I've been is not who I am, but who am I? It could really be like an identity crisis, but all of it is set in place, in motion, in order to help you to step into you being the leader, the executive decision maker of your life, but also that you're merging, you're aligning with people that match your vibration, that want the best for you, but also that you are doing the best for yourself. This is the week that you really want to say to yourself, you know what? This fear that I've been allowing to hold me back, I'm going to release it. I'm going to expel it. I'm going to push it out. It's no longer. And if I ever get the feeling, because Jupiter Pluto conjunction is going to keep giving you these urges. I don't know if you guys are picking up what I'm putting down, but it's kind of like, we can talk real here, you guys. We're all human beings here, and you guys know I bring it to you 100% authentic to the YouTube channel, Bahati Life YouTube channel, always. It's like the urge to poop. That's right. I said the urge to poop. Where else in the spirituality community are we talking about poop? We're going to be talking about it here. Why? Okay? Because Scorpio actually rules our body's ability to poop. That's the part of, that's, if we looked at the zodiac, Scorpio rules that ability to expel, okay? And also our ability to have an orgasm. But if we keep holding it and resisting this thing that the universe is saying to us, poop it out, release it, you're gonna be so uncomfortable and over time. And if you do it sooner rather than later, it's easier. But if you hold on to it, it gets harder, it gets more painful, and it can really make you sick. So as crazy as that metaphor is, it actually resonates as truth 1000%. This is the week of you have the urge to poop. Okay, why? Because Jupiter is the planet of expansion. It's the planet of abundance. It's the planet of, look, I'm in your face. Let's celebrate. We're here. We're present. We're right now. And Pluto is actually the sign, or it's actually the planet of purge, releasing, rebirthing, regeneration. So as you feel this desire, and then we have Scorpio, which actually rules that part of our body. So I mean, come on, you guys, like all of this energy right now is saying that there is this emotional urge that we're all feeling that says, listen, the time is now for us to release this. And it's not just these external things. That's the thing that's really standing out to me the most, you guys, intuitively, as I was writing my notes down and as I was prepping for you guys. I haven't even pulled the cards yet. We have the Judgment card and we have the Queen of Cups. And already I felt this so strong. It only supported what it was that I was feeling. So what I'm feeling is that you guys have, no offense, but hear me out. If this resonates, just realize that this is a sacred space and that I set powerful intention all the time to protect the Bahati Vibe tribe and to make sure that we're all safe and being supported here and that we're all being protected, okay? So the reason why I'm saying that is because, to be honest, the one thing that's coming through in this chart is this idea that some of you guys are very focused on healing, very focused on evolving and doing better, but you're almost looking at these external things and pointing the finger at these external stuff and being like, okay, well, I'm gonna get rid of this, 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 and this, these external things. But this week, with this urge, with this Jupiter-Pluto conjunction, the sign of Capricorn, and Mercury moving into the sign of Scorpio, and Chiron retrograde, Mars retrograde, now going to be turning direct on the 14th, and Sun sextile Pluto, and the Scorpio new moon. This is not about these external things. You've been there, you've done that. Be honest. Be honest. Drop a heart down in the comments if this resonates. You've been there, you've done that, but there's something inside. There's something that you are afraid of. There is something that you have fear there. There's an intimacy, a fear of success, or an intimate level. And as I'm saying that, my nose is lit up right now, itching. So like tickles, you guys know what that means. If you're part of the Bahati Vibe tribe, you know what that means. Like it's really like bothering me. All right, guys, sorry. I had to pause the video for a second because I just started sneezing like crazy because that's how lit up my nose is. And we're back. I'm not gonna allow that to derail me and distract me from getting this message out to you guys, because on SimReal, as I was saying, I can't help but to see the fact that there are, and this is what Spirit is telling me so clearly, that there are certain things that I feel like we are avoiding. And it has to do with this idea of intimacy. It has to do with this idea of fear of success. It's our inability sometimes to speak up for ourselves, to advocate for ourselves. And as Jupiter and Pluto are moving through the sign of Capricorn, Capricorn wants you to be powerful. It wants you to be mature. It wants you to be strong. It wants you to not only to believe in yourself, but take the steps to get you to where you need to be in the future. And it will secure you and support you for lifelong. Your goals, or what the universe has in store for you when it comes to its goals for you, are so massive. They're so major. But as soon as you start to see signs of things picking up or things producing, I don't know why that's the word that's coming through, things producing and, you know, pulling through, you cannot, and the universe is working to help you to observe, to see, and to do better with, you know, these tools, these resources, to help you to stop shrinking in fear and powerlessness or accepting. Sometimes you'll hear these things. Remember how I said in the beginning of the video with Mercury moving through the sign of Scorpio? It's the things that is you're allowing yourself to hear and to believe. There are certain messages that when you hear them, they take away your power immediately. And because it's the ego wounded child space, you know, that you are healing from and working to move away from, sometimes on your off days, you will believe that voice more than you believe your stronger voice. But with Jupiter-Pluto conjunction happening in the sign of Capricorn, all of these energies are working right now to help you and to cement into your brain this voice that is firmer, that is stronger, that is solid, that is there to support you, not just now, not just temporarily, not just temporarily, but for the years to come, for the rest of your life. This is in your work, this is in your health, this is in your relationships, this is in your mental health, it's in your communications, it's in your friendships. It goes on and on and on. It's gonna be lasting, and it's gonna be a legacy. So that's how serious this energy is, you guys, this week. And to be honest with you, you know, looking at this, there are some things that is that we need to release, we need to expel. This is, for those of you guys that ask me, like, Jess, what do you recommend when it comes to working magic, working in intention? So you can write down on a piece of paper or in a notebook things that it is that you want to, things that it is that you've been avoiding, things that it is that you're afraid to look at. It's not, some of you guys look at relationships and you're like, okay, there's this aspect of this person that I just, if once I get through this with them, then I'm gonna be healed. It's not them, babe, it's you. Internally, it's you. There's a belief within you that the ego child, the wounded child, believes what that person represents. And that's why you keep chasing it, because internally you're trying to heal that void. Internally you're trying to switch the voice up. But the best way to do that is by you focusing on and you seeing intimately what is disrupting you, what is derailing you, and learning from that and trying, striving and to do better, and then you'll be thriving as you are doing better. That's what this Jupiter-Pluto conjunction is all about. But we can't do it if we refuse to see the demon, if we refuse to see the problem, right? Fear of success. Some of you guys want a deeper connection, a soul connection, but as soon as you see it, start seeing signs of it, you're like, nope, can't be. Doesn't exist. Something's going on here. You start making all of these judgment calls on things that you don't even know about. If you have fear, give that fear to the universe. If you have doubt, give that doubt to the universe. What you need to do is, especially under this Jupiter-Pluto conjunction, is step more into your power. It comes from an emotional space, especially with the Queen of Cups here. It's very emotional. In order for you to do better and move past this, you have to at least be open to seeing it, first and foremost. Where did I put my tarot deck? Oh, here it is, perfect. All right, so those are some things that is that I wanna talk to you guys about. Look at this, the Empress. This is the Empress, you guys, that's jumping out for all of us. It doesn't matter what your identity is, where you're at currently at life, every single one of us has the Empress energy within us. And the universe, the divine, the powers that be are set into place to remind you of your worth, to remind you of your value. But you can't do that. I don't know if you guys see this, but half of her body is on the ground, sitting, and the other half of her body is in the ocean, the depths of her feelings, the truth, you know, of the darker shadow sides of herself, and, you know, her emotions, the ability to be intimate, all those things are there. She's half in, half out. And that's what I'm seeing for all of us, is that if you have the ability, Eight of Wands, it's coming in real fast, especially at the time of the new moon. The new moon's gonna be happening on the 15th. I am already seeing a massive, I don't wanna say lockdown, but it's a, you know, like, I don't know why, but I'm hearing like gearing. Like, there's certain things that are kind of gearing up to reveal themselves, to present themselves. you know, with the Empress energy and also the Queen of Cups, don't allow anything at the time of the Scorpio new moon, which is again around the 15th, but it's all this week that is that we're working with. It's the energy that is that we're working with. Your power is going to be in your ability to be vulnerable, to be soft, to be authentic, to speak your needs, and to not settle for anything less than it is that you deserve. If you ever find yourself chasing, trying to convince or persuade or force anything or anyone into taking care of you and treating you like the goddess, the queen that is that you are, you've already lost your power. You've exchanged your power. You've stepped into a space of weakness. That's the ego child, the wounded child, trying to be convinced of things that it doesn't believe. Okay, that's how serious that is. Jupiter-Pluto conjunction in the sign of Capricorn says, listen, you are solid, you are stable, you are safe. Everything that is that you could ever need is has already been provided for you since the moment that is that you were born. Your unique skills, talents, gifts, what makes you so distinct is going to be your gift. Don't allow anybody to move you away from that. Don't allow anybody to anger you, to be in a space where you are, you lose your rational thinking, you lose your ability to connect with your intuition, to trust your intuition, and to make movements and judgments that are for your highest and greatest good. Okay? That's how serious this is. It's beautiful. What else do we have here, Spirit? Okay, Four of Pentacles. This is, again, this feeling of we are secure, we are stable, we are solid. Okay? Even as I'm saying that, we have the waters rushing behind her. And the Eight of Wands. So this Scorpio new moon is very solidifying, but in the way of you really stepping into your emotions and you finding, you know, an anchor in all of that, an anchor in who you are, an anchor in your truth and in your trust in who you are and what can happen for you and what is happening for you. Scorpio energy, that's literally the truth, the Ace of Swords right here at the bottom of the deck. Scorpio energy is about being authentic and realizing that, you know, you can have so much depth and so much blessing if you're at least open to receiving it and being intimate with it. Whatever it is that you really want to value, whatever it is that you really want to hold, that you really want to secure into your life, especially when it comes to emotional fulfillment and happiness and joy, make sure that you are going to look at whatever it is that you're avoiding to that is blocking you from being open to receiving that, to being open to being receptive towards it. And anything that, you know, makes you feel defensive, on edge, triggered, you know, it's ask yourself, is this, like, what does this actually mean for me? What does this actually mean for me? I had a client last week, I think, who was in the midst of that. And look, High Priestess energy, Seven of Wands reversed, Page of Pentacles, Two of Pentacles reversed, and the Seven of Pentacles. That's a lot of Earth energy that's happening here. But I believe that Earth energy is coming through again because of the Jupiter-Saturn conjunction in the sign of Pluto, which is really trying to solidify and cement, you know, this solid, stable ground for you. And some of you guys are going to feel like you being open to receiving this level of success, or you stepping into this space in this new relationship, or you manifesting this thing that is, again, intimately, you know, I don't want to say triggering, but sometimes when you guys really, some of you guys set intention for these things, like, but there's this fear there that just wants to block you from receiving it, that wants to block you from being open to it, because again, the wounded child is screaming to you. It's the very thing that is that you need, the very thing that is that you're avoiding. The other thing that's coming through, especially with Earth energy, is the material. So, and this is very tangible evidence of the health, the body, making sure that you're taking care of any disruptions in the body, especially when it comes to sexual health, intimacy, things that is that you've been avoiding, and things that you have fear with. See, Wheel of Fortune. The more that, the sooner you change it, and when divine timing comes through and says, now's the time for you to take care of it, now's the time for you to see it and make it better, then it will start to turn, then it will start to become better, okay? But it can't happen if you're avoiding it. And you wanna make sure that, you know, if we're gonna be moving forward regardless. So if you have to move forward regardless, make sure that you're strong, make sure that you're solid, make sure that you're healthy. What are you doing now to make sure that you are thriving and vibrant? You know, look, Seven of Swords. This is what I'm saying, you guys. There's some things that I've been getting a lot of messages lately when it comes to secrets, and definitely with Scorpio energy. Scorpio rules secrets. You know, things that is that sometimes we may be uncomfortable dealing with and looking at, but don't let anything slide under the radar here with the Seven of Swords. we want to make sure that if something does, if something feels off and something isn't, doesn't feel right, or you're having pain or you're getting signs of something, that you go and you get it seen, especially this week, because there's so much energies here that are saying, listen, now's the time to make moves and action towards making sure that you are whole, that you are better. Okay, especially when it comes to your sexual health, especially when it comes to what it is that you are intimate with, who it is that you're intimate with, what it is that you are holding on to, those types of things, okay? So I hope that message makes sense, you guys. I know that that is a lot. A lot of you guys have been asking me about the Jupiter-Pluto conjunction, how that will be impacted, how that will be impacting you guys. I'm doing my best to get a video out there for you, but for the most part, it's what it is that I'm saying here about, you know, you really stepping in, learning how to step into your personal power, and you becoming an advocate for yourself. I mean, the best way that I can say it is that you're learning how to become the executive decision maker for your life. Like, you're not waiting for anyone to call the shots. How this is going to impact us on a global level and in business and politics and the economy is going to be very interesting. Mark my words. So I do want to get a video out there for you guys. Things are changing, and they're changing so rapidly, but I'm doing my best. You know, as I was saying, I've got the candles that I'm working on with my clients. I've got readings that I'm doing, predictions that I'm making, and, you know, all the other things that I've got going on that I love to do, but they also take up time. And you guys know me, I'm all about precision and accuracy and making sure that I'm doing it right, and then I'm giving it my full attention. So sometimes that can be a little bit of a delay. So I just want to thank everybody for being patient with me with videos and readings and all the other stuff that is that we've got going on, that the services that I provide. If you guys have any questions about that with readings or oils or intentions, you know, how to set intentions, all of that can be found on my website, thehottylife.com. Also, the Sacred Circle Tarot School is open for enrollment. That's one thing that you guys keep asking about. Just when is enrollment? When can we join in with the school? When can we dive into astrology and tarot and esoteric symbolism with you? Right now. All the links for that can be found down below in the description box. And if not, you can go ahead and check out thehottylife.com. For this week, for those of you guys that ask, if I was going to recommend an oil to work with, to set intention with, definitely the soulmate oil, definitely the goddess vibes oil, the intention oil, that thing is everything. You guys have been noticing that and calling me out on it on my Instagram, Bahati Life, and my personal Instagram, Jessica X Alexandria, where you're like, Jessica is definitely working with the fertility oil, which you guys have noticed. You guys have noticed that. I've been working with the fertility oil, and I've been working with my goddess vibes oil, and they have been just doing the most for me, like they always do. And also, I don't know if I said this, but the banishing oil is major. I haven't mentioned that because I have it set in for this week, actually. So roughly Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday are going to be my days where I'm going to be personally working with this same energy that I'm talking about right now. These things that is that we need to release that we may not, you know, be the most excited to look at, to examine, and our own fears and how they block us from manifesting our blessings, from manifesting our highest hopes and dreams. I have it too. So I'm going to be working with my banishing oil for that. I am going to be working candle magic. I am going to be partnering it up with the banished candle and the oil in order to help me to work through and to release my own personal blockages, you know, so especially right now. I mean, this week is all about it. So I will be sharing some videos about, you know, some videos as I'm doing my intention, as I'm doing my work from my altar. If you guys are interested, you can check that out on my Instagram, of course. And if you want the oil for yourself, it's never too late. You have the entire month in order to work with these energies. So yeah, as I was saying, sorry guys, I'm gonna stop the video again one more time, but yeah, the Jupiter-Pluto conjunction is not something that's going away overnight. So you have the rest of the month and then some to work with this energy, definitely. And if you have the oil already, or if you have your own stuff that is that you're working, that's what is I would recommend, especially with the Scorpio new moon on the 15th. And I'll have a video up there for you guys shortly as well. Probably going to do a pick a card reading. I don't know. Let me know what you guys want down in the comments. I really am open to hearing what works best for you. I wish I could do everything though. Like, I wish I could do the astrological, you know, transits and my predictions and share them publicly. I wish I could give out more information as far as these, you know, general questions that you guys are asking a lot, which are so valid and so good. and I want to be able to answer them for you. And then I also want to do the pick a card messages, but it's not just the YouTube channel that is that I have here. I have the full, you know, apothecary and readings and stuff like that in the school that take up a lot of my time. So I'm doing my best to balance all of it. Luckily for me, I love it. Luckily for me, I love you guys. And luckily for me, you know, this is just how I'm wired anyways. But if I can clone myself, believe me, I would. Until then, you guys, make sure that you are subscribed to the YouTube channel because there's plenty more videos where this came from. I'll see you in my next one. Be blessed. Bye.